Hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello. Hello. Hello, hello, hello.
Alright, so let's see. What does this sound like exactly? It's better than last time, that's for certain. Crazy voice. If I want to turn that up a little bit more, let's do this first. less use. Fights with mystics. Thank you. Hello there, Thanos. How's it going? Those out now. I think my sound's all right tonight. Fixed the crazy digitally thing that I had going on last time. Play tonight, which is nice. Last night the kids didn't go to bed until an obnoxious hour. I want to say it was like 10:30, and then by then I was so tired I just said, not worth it. Yeah, it's nice because the mic is pretty good actually. I think so at least. The unfortunate part was that last time, I believe what was happening was that I had added the mic two times because it like defaults to it, I guess, but I had added it as an audio capture, so it was like, that's why it was like a weird digital echoey kind of sound last time. It was like picking me up twice, but like one of them was like probably like a millisecond different. If you want to, I'm not gonna tell you not to. I just don't wanna like go around spamming people myself and whatever, you know. It's not how I wanna be. I don't wanna be that guy. So my plan is trying to stream or make a video every day. Obviously some days that's not gonna happen, but that's the idea. And then hopefully if I can do some useful content for people down the road as I go along, then you know people will see me and get to know me and want to hang out. Like I said, if you want to, I'm not gonna stop you. If it's somebody else doing it, then at least I can't be claimed as being me that's spamming other people's stuff, right? What servers do you server. I'm in Otrius's, or at least I was. I don't remember. Might still be in there. What's up, Aaron? How's life in Maw? Super behind on my event quest here. Been focusing too much on making videos and stuff. Oh yeah, Beardo. What's up, Esmer? Discord general. What's wrong with Discord general? Oh, yeah. Alright, hold on. We can do that. That is a good opportunity. I didn't even think about that. Got coffee grind, I get it. Still not watching, how rude. Welcome to the Espresso Show. Yeah, that'll be next time, definitely. You know, it's funny, I wasn't even trying to make a pun. That was not my intention by any means. It's just so easy to make coffee puns. Yeah, General Chad is we'll change it to the Cheese and Wine channel. Hitmonkey do anything special?
Hi, Amanda.
Oops. Stop paying attention for a second. That's what I get. Different. Yeah, I was trying to expend my energy. I'm gonna go into the Modok thing after this. That's my plan, at least. And then probably some arena. This is the first time I've even fought Hitmonkey. I'm that far behind.
What did we tell him, Mister? Took me a lot of Cav Crystals to pull Aegon. I won't even go into that. The only reason I ever did was Mr. Spudrific over there. Pulled him and I was like, you know what? He gave me hope. I'm going to try a couple more and got him after like three. Eternally grateful. Yeah, they haven't made any annoying defenders in a while, so we were due a couple. Well, what's up, Aloof? How's it going, buddy? I feel like it's been a while since Mojo came out, like 3 months, maybe 4 months. I don't even know now. I feel like he might only really be annoying because of flow, though. I mean, maybe I'm wrong. I remember Mole Man because it was so brutally horrible, that side of quest. I felt like I spent like a year of my life trying to explore all those paths. They went a little overboard on the paths, and also the fact that, actually no, they didn't require energy, did they? I don't remember now. I think it was no energy, but you had to use all of your real life energy trying to get through it, because it took like 16 hours worth of grinding. Thank you. even really sure what just happened. How did I just kill him there? Does anyone know what just happened? I'm gonna have to like go back and... Oh, okay, that makes sense. Forgot about that. What's up, Weapon X? How are you? I'll miss you. Come back soon. After this, I'm gonna jump into the, is it Modok Hotel? I don't even remember anymore. I remember there was labs, and then there was hotels, and oh, it's the island. Island of Dr. Modok. Play on the island of Dr. Moreau. They think they're clever, but they're not. Torches. Alright, sorry about that. I think I fixed it. So that was a mistake.
Alright, sorry about that.
Oop, you're gonna hear me talk to myself for a second there when I... Is that better now? My bad. I was trying to use my laptop for too many things, I think, and it was causing some back feed into the microphone or something. Hopefully it's gone now. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to blow anyone's eardrums out. Lessons learned. Don't try to run your... It was like, because I was trying to open the YouTube feed so I could watch the chat on my laptop at the same time on one place instead of having to look back and forth. So I've got like the chat up over here, and then I've got my OBS over here. So I tried to put them both in one spot, and apparently that was a terrible idea. Yeah, that was what it was. It was the neighbor blaring techno music. It wasn't me. Well, as long as you weren't fighting a rogue, we probably would be okay, right? I lost some people now. I blew their eardrums out and they said, screw you, we're out of here. Probably a bad idea. Yeah, this is a Destiny shirt. This is from when I played Destiny 1, and I think it was after year 1 of Destiny 1, they gave everyone the option of buying a t-shirt that completed all of the Acts of Valor, or whatever they called it then. So like you had to have done like every single one of the hardest things. And, yeah, it was like $27 or something like that. It's got my gamer tag on it. Yes, yes, I know it was explosive personality. Said it was a bad idea to do this. I should have healed up Domino first. That's where I went wrong. Actually, more curious how you knew it was a Destiny shirt. Maybe just from the symbols. Next up, Modok Land. What's everybody else up to tonight? Anything fun and exciting? I knew I should have brought somebody that armor break. Oops. Nope. Let's see what we got here. Present space, supercharge. I don't think that there's any way to get him to stop pulling Aegon. I don't think that's something that any of us have the power to do. Honestly, you should feel sad for him to a degree because he keeps pulling Aegon. Simply because he already has him at Sig 200 and he's had him at Sig 200 for like forever and a day. So all of those Aegons that he pulled could have been other champs that he actually needed. So in a way, he's the loser and not you. If you really think about it in the right, you know, scope. Hold on a sec. How do I, not that one, it's this one. Somebody texted me, so let me see what that's about real quick.
up now.
Oh, what's up, N9? Do you prefer N1 or N9? I don't think I've ever asked you that. For me too. That's why I didn't. I planned to stream last night, then when my kids wouldn't go to bed. I was so tired. I was like, there's no way I'm doing anything tonight. See, like N1 and N9 is just 9. I get it. Don't worry, I will refrain from going into any sort of war gameplay on stream, at least during seasons. I'm not going to do anything live during a season, that's for certain. That makes sense now that, you know. How long have we been playing together? I never even realized that that's what it was. I thought it was like an acronym for something. And I, you know, didn't get it. I mean, now that you say that, it makes perfect sense. I always assumed it was some sort of Star Wars thing that I didn't know, because you've always had like the Stormtrooper helmet as your pick. I was like, I don't know, maybe it's just something that I don't know, because I'm not like that into Star Wars. Don't get me wrong, I've seen all of the Star Wars multiple times. Except for Solo. I only saw that once just because I had to watch it, because like, you gotta see all the movies. It wasn't bad, but... Oops. Actually, that is something that we have to do still. We have to do, Room 6 incursions still for this month. Or Sector 6. Jay's getting an S3 from my S3, that was pretty nice. these days I'll get a real camera. Oh, we can wait. That's fine. We're on what reset anyways, so we've already got milestones for this set. So we may as well wait till reset so that we can get the milestones and the Sector 6 complete. So, what? Monday will work. I don't see why not. Do a little stream action. Incursions with Mr. Nine. Special one here. Yeah, maybe you just won't get stuck with a whole bunch of Ultrons. That would be good. Attention. I guess I have to actually pay attention a little bit during the island of Dr. Modok here. I also like that we don't have to do it each day, except now I'm backed up on them. not going well against Terrax. Oops. Brutal. Stupid spider. Got a little too overconfident there at the end. Wasting all my 20% revives that I worked so hard for. Oh, stupid Darkhawk. Oopsies indeed. And oopsies that cost me a revive for no reason. I think that Change up the team a little bit. I would bring Ghost in, but I don't want anybody to see how bad with Ghost I am still. Still figuring. I just got her, like, tech path with Corvus. I mean, I could do that if I didn't have him in AQ already. I'm only doing Mystic because I think it's, like, the Mystic day. It's Mystic Day for this thing. Wherever it is. Where is it? This thing? This thing? Somewhere? Oh, no, it's not that. It's this. Sorry. This thing. Dr. Modok's class use. Win a fight using a Mystic champion. And ideally a 6-star Mystic champion. So that's why I was using Symbiote Supreme for that whole path. That was the plan. But I don't think I need Doctor Strange. I think he's kind of a waste to bring with. Maybe... what would be a good idea would be this instead. Then if there's a sneaky little evady Spider-Man on the boss or something, then I have something to deal with that. Ooh. Tegra. Yes, Matthew Vaca, a.k.a. Blizz, is my bro. Oh, come over here like during a stream? Yeah, brother stream. Frozen coffee. Frozen coffee, get it? Because like Blizzard, Blizz. Frappuccino. But thank you. legs don't seem that small. I mean, his upper body's just, you know, swole. He's like the John Cena of the MCU. Yep, he's skipping leg day. Yeah, the next time that you try to fight with him, you're just gonna, or fight with or against him, you're gonna be sitting there staring at his legs, going like, why is his leg so small? And then you're just gonna get smacked in the face by an S2. Ooh, we've got Nova. Oh boy. My favorite person to fight against, Nova. Hopefully he's got some really stupid nodes like kinetic transference. Red-handed, he's gonna leave the stream now. S2. Oh, what happened to your phone? Oh, I should have looked at the nodes. Probably it was a mistake. Not doing much damage. 4 souls. Maybe I'll live. Oh. Silly me. Jesus. Nova. Why must you be this way? Hey, we made it through with Champ still alive, so... That's a plus. I haven't fought Tigra yet, so I'm gonna assume that I am having a rough go. But part of it's because I'm slightly distracted. Part of it is because weird not to have sound. For me, at least. Oh, right, it's Mighty Church. I just really want to intercept. Unblockable up close. This is gonna suck, probably, I bet. guess one's definitely the way to go. Hey, snuck that one out though. Should probably just switch over to Arena, something where I don't have to actually pay attention to what I'm doing. All right, see you later there, Matt. The point is, you do your arenas while you watch the stream. That's the pro move. Who do I got left in here? I got, Amanda and, Nine? There's probably a way to, like, see who the... Audio sounds better, though, tonight, right? Thanos off stream part 2. I know J. Paul typically can't hop into these streams until 10:30 or so, I think. Putting the kids to bed and stuff. So I've been trying to think of what videos I should make now. I want to try to focus on, like, instructional, like, how-to type videos. But I don't really know what to do. I mean, obviously when, like, a new month comes along, you can do stuff like how to fight champion, but like all that stuff's been done for this month. Kind of waiting on the announcement of, I'm really hoping they put out an announcement with like the roadmap tomorrow. Because I really want to see what's in there. Because I feel like the future of my content to a degree where we rely on what is or is not inside of a roadmap. I know, like, me personally, when we started doing map 7, there really is not a whole lot of good information out there about Map 7. So I've been debating on whether it would be a good idea to put like a video together of, you know, Map 7 planning kind of thing. Especially now that the tickets are a thing and costs are a little bit lower. There might be more alliances trying to delve into Map 7, so I don't know. I just, you know, there's a lot of people that play this game that don't do that. So I just don't know if there's an audience necessarily for it or not. But yeah, I mean, yeah, but like if there's something in the roadmap about it changing, I don't want to do a video about like, oh, here's how you run Map 7, and then they go, oh, well, yeah, we're going to change Map 7 entirely, and then all of a sudden throw that hours of my life out the window. Right? Yeah, trust me. Would have been helpful for me, too. I had, like, zero information when I started planning Map 7 for us. The extent of the information I got was paths from another alliance who was running it. Do I think that they're going to make changes to Map 7? I don't know what they're going to make changes to, honestly. I know there, you know, obviously some of the concerns people have is whether, you know, AQ specifically being a little bit too reliant on links and coordination and all that stuff. So it's very possible, in my mind at least, that there may be some sort of changes to that. Now, what that is, I don't know. Personally, I don't like the fact that there's, I mean, I understand why they went to the multiple variations thing, but I'm not a big fan of all the different variations, especially now that they're adding that into Map 6 as well. Makes things a little bit more difficult for officers to plan out so many things. Yeah, I don't think they're going to be able to, you know, going back to your last, I don't really think that they're going to be able to quell all of the angst in the community, partially because they've taken so long at this point, in my mind, to put out a roadmap. I think that they've dragged it out so far at this point that they've shot themselves in the foot. Like, to me, like, they should have put out a roadmap a lot earlier. And if they don't do it tomorrow, then it's gonna be even worse, because the longer you go, the higher the expectation of what you're going to put out is. And I just don't think that they can put out anything having this much time having been elapsed that's going to satisfy people. They should have, you know, in my mind, if I was doing it, I would have probably put out, like, every Friday, say, like, here's part one, you know, like, this is a three-part roadmap, here's part one, here's the stuff that we know from this, we'll have more parts coming, that way you can just kind of, like, keep a steady flow of information out there. I think, like, the number one rule of PR is to, like, get ahead of get ahead of the information or whatever, you know, control the discussion. You don't want to allow the discussion to go on outside of your realm of control. So the fact that they've essentially said nothing and done nothing is, in my mind, makes it worse for them. So will be interesting to see, though. Welcome to the channel, Tony. I agree. I think that the map. Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Well, I appreciate your, you know, racking my numbers up. That's cool. You know, get that viewership going. Three devices. You have me on three devices. It's like surround, coffee surround. I didn't even know you were still here, Thanos. Play some MCOC. Get some arena in. Watch a little stream. Sounds good to me. Probably just gonna run through my 550s and then that might be it for me for the night. It's a horrible life having responsibilities and having to be up at, you know, 5 a.m. to get ready for work. What doesn't sound like you, Thanos? responsibilities. I mean, everybody has some responsibilities. Some of us have more than others.
I really need to start grinding arena more. Actually, it doesn't take as long as as it seems. Just so monotonous. Definitely monotonous when they just sit in the corner block and they're a bunch of jerks.
Tony and Amanda are living the high life up here in Thanos with us. They get to take all the hard paths in Map 7. And they get to use loads and loads of items. But they don't complain because they're quality people. Beauty and the horror of making your own paths for AQ is that you almost feel bad if you put other people on like the really stupid paths. So you put yourself on the stupid paths and then you regret it instantly. Yeah, I always feel bad if I'm planning map 7 and I'm like, oh, I'll give myself these three cake paths and then I'll stick that guy on those. You can take Can't Stop, Won't Stop and you can take One Eye Open with Void on it. Let somebody else do all that shenanigans. Thank you.
This AI is brutal. Do something. Oh, I guess he did something.
So yeah, Corvus is one of the better options, I think, for Can't Stop, Won't Stop. Tomy and I, we split half and half now for it. So I feel like that's the ideal option. So you've got the Caustic Temper path that goes at the top. And then just below it, you've got Can't Stop, Won't Stop. And what we do is... I'll move up and I bring Symbiote Supreme and I'll take Champion Fight, and I've also got Corvus. So I'll take first go at the Ultron, whittle him down a little bit and try to get one charge for Corvus from the evade charge. Then I leave him for Tomy to finish. So then Tomy theoretically gets two charges from that fight, being evade and then tech. And then he has Medusa and he takes Caustic Temper. He takes the first little bump of Caustic Temper. And then I come back down and up and I take CMM, take Captain Marvel with Symbiote Supreme again. And then after that, he takes... the Yondu fight with Corvus again, and then I go up and take, what is it like? Is it Hulkbuster? I don't remember now. No, it's Howard the Duck. Howard the Duck, and whatever the other one is. I'll take those two. So I'll have Symbiote Supreme for Champion and for... CMM, and then I've got Medusa, who takes the Caustic Temper fights that I take there, and then I've got Corvus, who takes the, he just gets a charge there, and then, Corvus I use for Section 2 and Section 3, Section 2 being the, I take Can't Stop, Won't Stop in Section 2 as well. And I use Corvus for those fights. If I have Symbiote Supreme still alive, I can use him for those fights as well. Because Symbiote Supreme, just that bleed that he does with the S3 and then his fangs phase, he pretty much tears through most of that stuff in Section 2. So splitting it seems to work pretty well. Just that way no one person has to take all of those super annoying fights, and you almost can't even bring enough options. Complaining about map 6 over here, this guy. Oh, yeah. I'm actually pretty excited that they said that map 5 is going to... they're going to change the AI over for it to the real AI instead of the stupid block in the corner passive shenanigans. Honestly, I don't even think I've done map 5 since they've had drones. We debated on it
when the Corvus battle group came over, there was some discussion that went on about what maps we should run, and there was debate on should we run 5x5 for that week just to take a week off, basically, but we needed our glory, so we decided to stick with map 6. Corvus tears through everything once he has charges. There's very few things that he doesn't. Especially if he's duped, because then he can pretty much just not die from anything, pretty much. It, you know, as long as you don't get hit. I live in Michigan. It felt like it took forever for me to get my Corvus duped. I'm at 565. I feel like for a whole year before I managed to pull him the second time. He did really well for me even that, in that time, though. There was a lot of, I know, like, back in the day, there was a lot of discussion about people saying, like, it's not necessary, he doesn't need to be duped to be, you know, beyond God tier, whatever you want to call it. I personally think that he kind of does, maybe more so now than he did back then, simply because of, there's so many higher utility champs out there than there used to be. Better, you know, the utility champs are better than what they used to be, so that kind of pushes the envelope for the high tier champs to also have utility. And without his dupe ability, he really doesn't have as much utility as he needs to, so he's pretty much just pure damage. Which is fine, but it doesn't, you know, for AQ specifically, the Sig ability, it's like night and day difference. Because you can pretty much just like survive on any path, you know. You don't have to worry about dying anymore. You can be on a degen path and just like sit there at one hit point. As long as you've got a glaive charged up, you're not going to die. Aspect of nightmares becomes like instant multiple potion heal. If you get skill or cosmic, you're awakening Corvus. How is it that you plan to awaken Corvus with a skill? Oh, because you have a generic. Is that what you mean? You have a generic, so if you get a skill, then you can use your generic on him. And you can save the skill for Aegon. That's my assumption. I know a lot of people have, like, tons and tons of 5-star Sig stones. A lot of people have a lot of 5-star awakening gems. I don't really know. People just really want to hold on to them for those perfect champs, and, you know, more power to them, but I'd prefer to just awaken somebody that I feel like I can get use out of right now.
Section 3. Oh, for Starburst, yeah. I really like it for, my favorite interaction is the aspect of Nightmare's Path. So, what is it? Is it G? G in Section 1, where there's that there's Thor and there's Iron Man Infinity War, typically. And then Iron Man Infinity War has aspect of Nightmares on it. And it's a 50% heal, so if you just run single double-edge suicide, when the even if you start the fight, like if you mess up against Thor and you end up with like 10% hit points, you end up healing back up to like 65% or something like that from the aspect of Nightmares. It's like the equivalent of three or four tier four healing potions. So that's always nice. I've taken, I want to say at this point I've probably taken every path in map 6 at one point or another. Not on the new map 6, mind you, I'm talking the OG map 6. Cosmic Awakening Gem is the one that I have pulled the most of. And I've never really had, you know, they say like if you have one in your inventory that you have a higher likelihood of pulling it again, blah blah blah. And I don't necessarily disagree with that. I actually think that is accurate, but I've always used mine right away and I still keep getting Cosmic. I've gotten, I think, like 5 Cosmic Gems. I used one on my Medusa, I used one on Corvus, and that was before I finally pulled him for the second time. I used one on Hype, I used one on, I don't even remember who else now. And, you know, that's part of the reason why I've always used them right away or as fast as I could, because, like, I don't want to chance the fact of that I'm going to continue to pull the same class over and over and over again because this game sees that I have one already and then just, like, forces another one on me. So I'd rather, you know, try to use it as quickly as possible, and then hopefully that allows me to get a different one that I actually can use a little bit better. Thank you. Imagine if we could swap 2 5-star awakening gems of the same class for a 5-star of your choice. That actually would be a fantastic idea, I think, but then you wouldn't have as much reason to buy deals for awakening gems. So, I do hope that there's at least some sort of mention when they do put out the roadmap, whenever it comes, about things that are currently totally RNG and changing over to a somewhat choice-based system to more of a degree. You know, I know that's, again, one of the bigger issues within the community is there's just so many champions and it's like impossible at this point to get anything useful for a lot of people. It's just, it's a hard thing to balance. I was going to say, Kabam won't let you what? They won't let you trade your 2 gems in for 1, I know. They won't let you have Torture Void. Yeah, they wouldn't let me, they won't let me have a few things either, you know? Captain America Infinity War still evades me. I haven't been able to get a Sparky. And it's funny because when I started playing this game, it was right when Spider-Man... Oh, shoot, I can't remember the name of the first one. I want to say it's not Far From Home. Far From Home is the newer one. Homecoming. Spider-Man Homecoming. Right when that came out, and the first champ that I had in this game was Stark Enhanced Spider-Man as a 2-star, and I used him for everything. And now, to this day, I still don't have a 5-star. You would think from all those 5-star crystals that you'd be able to pull them at least one time. Thank you. was nice though back then. And like thinking back at it, like I was pretty lucky, I imagine, because you know, they only gave them away for that 1 month. So I just happened to start playing at just the perfect time to get a, you know, beyond god tier champ to use for all the content that you could possibly use him for. I mean, he was viable for so much, and I mean, realistically, he still is. I kind of wish that I had been streaming for when rifts were going on. I had... oh, man. I had gone up north. And so I had a few days of, like, where I didn't do any rifts. And I got back and I had, like, five or six keys that I had acquired at that point. And I was like, okay, well, we'll knock these all out one night. Let's do this thing. And I got 2 5-star featured crystals from my first two runs. Then I got a 10,000 5-star shards. I think it was like a 5,000 5-star shards and then a Tech Awakening gem, like all in a row. 2 5-star awakenings, damn. Yeah, that's crazy. I didn't get that lucky. But yeah, so those 2 featured crystals, featured 5-stars that I got were like 2 meme tier champs. So I was super excited about it when it happened. And then right as soon as I pulled the champs from the crystal, I was like, well, that was a total waste because... well, that's the end of my 550s. That is rough. Yeah, you know what? That was what the first time that Nine and I ran incursions, that was what did us in, was Nick Fury. And we had to give up. I want to say we had to give up on Room 9 because of probably that exact combination. But we had him, it was like Room 7, 8, and 9. Like, all in a row. Nick Fury boss, Nick Fury boss, Nick Fury boss. And we had to swap out a champ. Because, you know, we didn't have anybody left to even fight him. Sometimes I feel like the incursion's luck that you get is just, like, one time you'll get, like, an easy go. And then the next time you just, they're like, nah, you're not doing it. Screw you. And they just gave you the worst combinations. Ooh, that sounds terrible. Incursions is a pretty cool game mode. I really do enjoy incursions. I just don't know that Incursions was the thing that was needed to be developed when they did it. It was kind of like dungeons were cool and they could have probably just left dungeons alone and maybe changed out some nodes, refreshed the champs that were in there and like left it alone. And it would have been fine for a while. But then they did like Incursions and it was kind of weird because nobody was saying like, oh, dungeons need to be redone. There's so many other things that could have been addressed, and the the fact that they chose to do that was just baffling to me. I still don't understand why that was the decision that was made. If you had a duped Thanos, or sorry, not duped Thanos, if you had a duped Corvus, he would be able to not die from the no retreat damage. Then, dupe, important. Could I not? Oh, so not only could I not parry, I see. Didn't have Corvus then? Your life must be miserable. No Corvus back, no Corvus. Just got Corvus. No dupe on him. No Aegon. Alright, well, it is past my bedtime. I believe I'll be calling it a night here, do my moves in AQ, do my moves in war, then go to bed. Been nice having you all here with me. Spend some time. Tell your friends, tell your loved ones. Stop by the channel. Spread the word.